Why is RDP still an attack method of choice for cyber criminals? This is a Week in Security by ESET. Keep listening to find out more. At some stage, you assume people have listened and closed the open door, but how wrong this assumption is. I recently witnessed someone log into an RDP client to gain access to their work email. A click on the desktop instance inside the RDP app and up pops the familiar Windows facade, and hey presto, they're connected to their full desktop environment. This was off-premise and on their own device. The endpoint was not part of the domain, so a cache domain password was in the RDP client. No multi-factor authentication, no VPN, no compliance check on the connecting device. Should I continue, or are you getting the picture? Through the pandemic transformation years and the significant noise made around securing RDP access, I never considered that some environments just ignored the warnings and continued as is. And for reference, the Verizon Data Breach Report of 2023 lists remote desktop sharing as the second most common method of entry for a data breach at over 30%. So I dedicate this week's Week in Security video as a call for all those using RDP in their environment to step up their security. So let's quickly look at some of those basic steps. Use strong passwords, enable multi-factor authentication. This is not rocket science. Patch all the device and software being used in the chain to gain access. Unpatch leaves the door wide open. Limit RDP access to internal IP addresses only and place a VPN between the end user device and the connection to the organization's network. And of course, patch the VPN and enable multi-factor authentication. Limit access to RDP by user, by app, by time, by location. Think about it, just not everybody all of the time. And use the tools provided. Enable account lockout to stop brute force and credential stuffing attempts, and leave network level authentication on by default. There is a great white paper on securing RDP available on welivesecurity.com. Use the QR code being displayed on the screen now to access it. Please, please take action. There is no excuse not to do the things that are no cost items on this list. For more cybersecurity news, check out welivesecurity.com. Stay safe, stay healthy, and be sure to watch our future videos.